These are Instagram, Snapseed, and Lightroom mobile apps running natively on Windows PC without any emulator. We will go step by step on how to set up the Android system, install apps, and move files between Android system and the Windows File Explorer. I'm on Windows 11 here. For the apps to work, we need to install Windows Subsystem for Android, and here are the minimum requirements required as per Microsoft. Main thing to note, Windows 11 is a must. The requirements to install Windows 11 is another matter. Before installing Windows Subsystem for Android, we need to enable Virtual Machine Platform. Click the Start button, search for Turn Windows Features On or Off, and open it. Here, scroll down and enable Virtual Machine Platform. Press OK. We'll take a moment to make required changes. Now, go to the browser and paste this link to go to the Microsoft Store page of Windows Subsystem for Android. I will leave these links in the description. Click the Get in Store app button and open Microsoft Store from the pop-up. Here we are in the Microsoft Store page of WSA. Click Install. Ignore the Amazon App Store ad and click Next and Download. This will download and install Windows Subsystem for Android. We don't need Amazon App Store here as we will eventually be sideloading apps. Now we can go to the Windows button and directly search for the installed subsystem and open it from here. Next, we need to download Android SDK Platform Tools. Just Google SDK Platform Tools and open the first link. Here, click Download SDK Platform Tools for Windows. Accept the conditions and click the link below to download the zip file containing the tools. Takes a second and it is done. Opening the zip, I will copy the platform tools folder and paste it into the C drive. You can place it anywhere. Just to make it easy for the video, I place it in the C folder. Looks clean here. Contents in the folder. Now I need to download the APK files. APK Mirror is a trusted site, so downloading the APKs here. We'll search for Snapseed, go to the latest update, and download the APK. We'll also download Instagram, Lightroom, and Firefox app, which we need later. These four APKs downloaded. You can shorten the name if you want. We'll keep it as it is here. We'll copy these and paste the APKs in the Platform Tools folder. Now we need to set up the subsystem. We'll search for command prompt and run it as administrator. Here I will change the directory to the Platform Tools folder. Here we'll key ADB devices to see if any devices are listed. There are none. Now in Windows Subsystem, go to the Developer tab and enable Developer Mode. Now you can see the IP and port numbers. Sometimes the IP number doesn't appear immediately like this. In that case, just toggle Developer Mode on off a couple of times or open Manage Developer Settings. Now if toggled on, the IP appears. Seems to be a bug. Go back to command prompt, connect manually by typing ADB connect with the whole IP and port number and enter. Here we get this pop-up. Just check always allow from this computer and click allow. Now type ADB device and you can see the device listed below. To install the APKs, here we'll start with Snapseed. Copy the name of the file. In command prompt, key ADB install and paste the file name. Don't forget to key the extension .apk. Now enter and the app is installed successfully. Now if you go to start, you can see the Snapseed app. We'll install the other APKs too. Now you can close the command prompt. opening the Instagram app here. It opens with the dimensions of a phone screen. So logging in with my credentials here. As with the new device logins, it verifies for authentication. We'll confirm here. Allowing required permissions. You can see we can scroll, like the notifications, everything as in the mobile version. You can also post photos from here. Closing, and we'll now open Snapseed editing app. So here I will allow permission for photos here. But as you can see, everything is blank here. We can't open any photos here as there is no option to copy files between Windows File Explorer and the Android one. We'll fix this issue now. Go to Start and open Run and paste this here. We'll share this in the description. This will take us to Environment Variables. Go to Path by selecting and clicking on the Edit button. Now copy the Platform Tools path. Add it on the second line and press OK. One more step remaining to make this work. Open Notepad. Paste these commands here. Need to save this with .bat extension. Rename it as you like. Here naming it as file transfer as that seems relevant here. Also adding .bat at the end. Save and close it. You can see the file here. We'll change the icons to large to make it easier to see the next step. Here I have an image in this folder as this is the one I'll be transferring. You can do this with folders too. Now I will drag the image file directly onto the file transfer .bat file and leave. And here you can see it has been pushed successfully to the subsystem. Now, in the subsystem, if you open the files from the shortcut here, you can see it in the download folder. In Snapseed, we'll import the image from the downloads folder. Here is the Snapseed app fully working on Windows. There is a slight learning curve here, especially for pinch and zoom. The remaining controls are basically like on mobile devices. Here, if you want to zoom in using the scroll wheel, gives these weird results. The right way is to use the control key plus scroll wheel. Control plus scroll up zooms in, control plus scroll down zooms out. You have also these configuration options in subsystem if you want to try them out. Other than this, it works the same way as the mobile devices. After saving, it will be placed in the relevant folder. Now, how to move the saved image to Windows File Explorer? There are different ways to do it, like setting up SFTP and so on, but I'll go the easier way here. Opening the Firefox app, logging into Google account and opening Drive. Here, we'll change this to desktop mode and upload the file from the Android system. You can download the file on any device now. Next to the Lightroom app. We'll log in to my account. There are already photos synced into my account. Again, it works the same as in any mobile device. The system still has some bugs and sometimes it may disconnect. Hopefully this will get fixed soon. Let me know in the comments below whether this works for you and how the response of the apps is on your laptops and PCs. If you want to remove these apps from the start menu, find the app and just right click and uninstall. See you in my next video.